Stop. Before you consider taking drastic measures to lose weight, like GLP-1 injections, consider Golo. Golo's release is easier than injections and fad diets. No need to jump through insurance hoops. It's simple. You take one release supplement with each meal. Golo's release supplement contains 7 natural plants and 3 key minerals that target body fat and combat the stress of dieting. With Golo, you follow the Golo for Life plan, where you'll safely and effectively control sugar cravings and hunger while minimizing muscle loss, allowing you to feel good and inspired to reach your goal weight. With Golo, you get an effective and affordable weight loss solution that's clinically proven. Because controlling glucose, maintaining healthy insulin levels, and saying goodbye to starvation dieting is the secret to lasting weight loss and wellness. Visit Golo.com to get started today. That's Golo.com. Go to Golo.com to join the 5 million people who have switched to Golo as a better way to lose weight. Visit Golo.com today.
Live from the 107th floor of the Cat Country 107.3 studios, just outside beautiful Atlantic City, New Jersey, it's the Joe and Jahna Sunrise Challenge. It's your chance to fire up your brain and show South Jersey exactly who you are. Now, here are your hosts, Joe and Jahna.
Jahna, who's our contestant today?
Trace from Nashville.
Actually, it's country superstar Trace Adkins from Nashville. Trace, good morning.
Good morning.
Welcome to the Joe and Jahna Sunrise Challenge. We have a contest question for you in a second, but first, kind of a practice question, a warm-up question, if you will. Trace, Jahna and I were talking yesterday about your movie Lincoln Lawyer, the movie with Matthew McConaughey where you played a big biker guy who was like in charge of a biker gang.
It's so epic.
Eddie Vogel was your character's name, I believe. Now, it's my contention, Trace, that in that movie, you just kind of played yourself because that's you. Is that true?
I play myself in pretty much every movie I do.
But certainly, that's the easiest role you ever played. It had to be.
All I play are bikers and cowboys. And, you know, it's I just say the words they want me to say.
So if we need you to kill somebody next week, you could be the guy we call. All right, here's your official Joe and Jahna Sunrise Challenge question, Trace Adkins. In 10 seconds, give us your 5 biggest musical influences. Go.
Ronnie Millsap, Merle Haggard, Waylon Jennings, my grandfather, and my uncle.
That works. You did it.
You actually grew up in a musical household and with a gospel background, correct?
That's right, yeah.
I love the fact that you mentioned Ronnie Millsap.
Yeah, I love Millsap. I made no secret about it when I came to this town, and the first producer that I sat down with, he asked me what kind of records I wanted to make, and I said I want to make Ronnie Millsap records. I've always liked the way Ronnie made records. You couldn't put him in a box, you know. He wasn't this kind of artist or that kind of artist. He just did whatever he wanted to do, and I set the bar too high for myself, but you know, but that's what I tried to do.
Well, Trace Adkins, we're happy to tell you, you've won the Cat Country Sunrise Challenge. Congratulations.
You did it.
This has been the Joe and Jahna Sunrise Challenge from Cat Country 107.3. Waking up with Joe and Jahna.
All right, boy. This is her favorite song. You know that, right? So we play it good and loud. She might get up and dance again. Oh, she put her beard down. Here she comes. Left, 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 right, left.
Ooh.
Hustlers shooting 8-ball, throwing darts at the wall. Feeling down there 10 feet tall. Here she comes, Lord help us all. OT'd up his girlfriend and slapped him out his chair. Poor old boy, it ain't his fault. It's so hard not to stare at that honky-tonk. But don't get gone. Keeping perfect rhythm, make you wanna swing along. Got it going on like don't get caught. And ooh, you shut my mouth, slap your grandma. There ought to be a law. Get the sheriff on the phone. Lord have mercy, how's she even save her. It ain't right to hate her for working that money maker. Banjo's down at 2, but we're hanging out till 3. We hate to see her go, but love to watch her leave. With that honky-tonk, but don't be done. Now keeping perfect rhythm make you wanna swing along. Got it going on like Donkey Kong. And ooh, shut my mouth, slap your grandma. There ought to be a law, get the sheriff on the phone. Lord have mercy, how she even get them bitches on with that honky tonk, but don't be dumb.
Country 107.3 Mornings with Joe and Jahna. Trace Atkins. Our thanks to Trace for joining us on our Joe and Jahna Sunrise Challenge. Trace is going to be back with us a little bit after 8 o'clock this morning to talk more. Of course, he's at the Hard Rock front of 6 o'clock. Welcome to a Thursday morning. Rosh Hashanah Day. It's Global Smoothie Day.
Do you we haven't had smoothies in a long time.
I think that's what Rosh Hashanah means. I mean, I think it means global smoothies.
It doesn't, but we have to get smoothies because we haven't gotten them in a couple months.
It's Boyfriend Day. If you're not posting photos of your boyfriend on social media, do you even have a boyfriend?
It's family
TV show day. Jahna, in the old days, families used to sit down and watch TV shows together.
That's
before we all had our own screens in our old bedrooms.
Yeah, that's crazy. It's not like they wanted to. They just had to do it.
It was what you did. You sat down and watched TV together.
That's so sweet. Oh, so wholesome.
In the same room. Good morning. We're Joe and Jahna. Here are three things you need to know this morning. Just how high was your electric bill last month? A congressional panel will be holding a public hearing next Tuesday into a surge in bills for customers of Atlantic City Electric.
Yep.
Congressman Jeff Van Drew is hosting the field hearing at the Atlantic County Institute of Technology Performing Arts Center in Mays Landing. In a statement announcing the hearing, some customers have said their bills increased by as much as 400% this summer.
That's outrageous. Well, a major strike by thousands of members of the International Longshoremen Association right here in New Jersey and elsewhere has led to consumer panic buying of toilet paper despite no direct threat to its supply. Now, that isn't panic here. That was from Australia during the pandemic when fights broke out over toilet paper. Oh, my gosh. Social media posts show empty shelves at retailers like Costco, fueling concerns of a shortage. However, experts attribute the perceived shortage to hoarding behavior rather than actual supply issues. Most toilet paper in the U.S. is produced domestically. Manufacturers have adequate buffer inventory. So,
and you have 10 more days to experience Gillian's Water Wonderland Pier in Ocean City. After 94 years, the Boardwalk Amusement Park will be closing forever a week from Friday.
It's so sad. But your South Jersey weather for today, some morning clouds and some afternoon sun with a high of 74.
Weather brought to you by Atlantic City Electric. Storm season is here. Atlantic City Electric knows a little prep makes a big difference. See how you can stay connected during storms. Prepare to weather any weather at AtlanticCityElectric.com/. Time for Jahna's Fangirl Update.
Listen, Jelly Roll is one of the sweetest guys you're ever going to meet. Trust me. But don't get it twisted, though. He's not afraid to put you in your place. And that's what he had to do with a Karen who commented on Twitter, X, whatever you want to call it, asking how long it would take for him to get sued by John Denver's people for the similarities between Country Roads and Jelly's new song with MGK called Lonely Rose. Long story short, Karen, you got cooked. Jelly Roll revealed that not only did they check with the John Denver estate to see if it was okay, but they even listed the writers of Denver's song on the new one with MGK. He ended his response by thanking Karen for her legal advice. We've got Jelly Roll's clapback at the internet, Karen, right now at country1073.com. Moving on to a sadder note this morning, Darius Rucker and his touring family, they're mourning the loss of someone who spent more than two decades working with him on the road. Jason Parkin was his name. He died this week. He was Rucker's longtime production manager. We've got more on that right now on the Cat Country 107.3 app. The Jahna's fangirl up.
10 chances to win. $30,000 is our top prize. We're going to have 10 cash winners today. Your first chance to play and win is at 8:20 this morning.
Early money.
Also coming up later this morning at 7:20, is Jahna's trending up or trending down?
Yeah, today we're talking about pumpkin spice. Are we over it? And I want to know, what is your favorite pumpkin spice? Where is the best place to get it? Are we done with Starbucks? You let me know on the app, or you can call us 609-383-1073. Let us know on Facebook, whatever method to get a hold of us tickles your fancy. Pumpkin spice, trending up or trending down.
It's Cat Country 107.3, Mornings with Joe and Jahna. We've got Cash Cow today, 10 chances to win. $30,000 is the top prize. First code will come your way at 8:20. We'll give you codes every hour through 5:20 p.m. 20 minutes past every hour, you get a code. You go to the Cat Country 107.3 app. You input your code, and we call you and tell you you won money. Cat Country 107.3, Mornings with Joe and Jahna. It's time for your Cat Country joke of the morning. So I've been holding onto this joke for literally most of the year.
Oh, wow.
I wanted to get as far away from Easter as possible for this joke. So,
oh, God. Lord. Lord,
forgive us now.
It's me again.
This is from Nicholas. Nicholas, thank you very much.
Nicholas.
Ladies and gentlemen, from Nick, your Cat Country joke of the morning.
Here we go.
So there's a big crowd gathered around Jesus. He's up on the cross.
Oh, no.
Jesus is heard weakly calling for Matthew. Well, Matthew rushes toward the cross, but is brutally beaten back by the Roman soldiers guarding it. He runs around to the far side and tries again, but again, he's beaten back. Finally, after several more attempts, a beaten and a bloody Matthew makes his way to Jesus and the cross. Yes, Lord, what do you have to tell me? Jesus says, Matthew, I can see your house from up here.
Oh, my God. I'm sorry.
Cat Country 107.3. Cat Country 107.3, Mornings with Joe and Jahna coming up at 7:20. Trending up or trending down with Jahna?
We're talking about pumpkin spice this morning. Is Starbucks pumpkin spice your favorite spot to get pumpkin spice? Do you have somewhere that you prefer? Mm. Is pumpkin spice still as popular as it was, or do you want everybody to just shut up about it? Pumpkin spice, trending up, trending down. Let us know, 609-383-1073. Or you can message us on the Cat Country 107.3 app. Pumpkin spice, trending up or trending down? You tell us at 7:20.
Country 107.3, Mornings with Joe and Jahna. Time now for your Cat Country dumb story of the morning.
And we're going where?
Gdansk, Poland.
Okay.
Excuse me, sir. Is that meat in your pocket, or are you happy to see me? Police pinned a meaty crime on a supermarket employee. They say the man walked out of work one day with $1,000 worth of meat stuffed down his pants.
I want to know what that looks like.
$1,000. I know prices are high at the supermarket, but $1,000 worth of meat in your pants? That's a bigger than normal bulge.
How do you even put one foot in front of the other?
Good morning.
This October, Tanger invites you to shop pink and save lives. Your donation of $10 or more to the Breast Cancer Research Foundation helps fuel innovative research that brings us closer to a cure. It also unlocks exclusive savings from brands like Coach, Crocs, Columbia Factory Store, and more to shop all month long. Join us as we mark 30 years of advancing research and empowering hope. Donate and access your exclusive savings today at Tanger.com.
Things you need to know this morning. Just how high was your electric bill last month? A congressional panel will be holding a public hearing next Tuesday into a surge in bills for customers of Atlantic City Electric.
Yep.
Congressman Jeff Van Drew is hosting the field hearing at the Atlantic County Institute of Technology Performing Arts Center in Mays Landing. In a statement announcing the hearing, some customers have said their bills increased by as much as 400% this summer.
That's outrageous. Well, a major strike by thousands of members of the International Longshoremen Association right here in New Jersey and elsewhere has led to consumer panic buying of toilet paper despite no direct threat to its supply. Now, that isn't panic here. That was from Australia during the pandemic when fights broke out over toilet paper. Oh my gosh, social media posts show empty shelves at retailers like Costco, fueling concerns of a shortage. However, experts attribute the perceived shortage to hoarding behavior rather than actual supply issues. Most toilet paper in the U.S. is produced domestically. Manufacturers have adequate buffer inventory. So,
and you have 10 more days to experience Gillian's Water Wonderland Pier in Ocean City. After 94 years, the Boardwalk Amusement Park will be closing forever a week from Friday.
It's so sad. But your South Jersey weather for today, some morning clouds and some afternoon sun with a high of 74.
Weather brought to you by Atlantic City Electric. Storm season is here. Atlantic City Electric knows a little prep makes a big difference. See how you can stay connected during storms. Prepare to weather any weather at AtlanticCityElectric.com/ Of course, it's Cat Country 107.3. Morning birthday shout-outs start now. Happy birthday to Bill Kennedy of Folsom. Bill is 66.
Bill, happy birthday.
In addition, Bill and his wife Susan are celebrating their fourth wedding anniversary. Congratulations. Happy birthday to Maddie Fowler of Eldora. Maddie is 22.
Aw, happy birthday, Maddie.
Barbara Hamill of Whiting is 82.
Nice.
Gerald Dougherty of Corbin City is 62. Happy birthday to Pat Grant of Tuckerton is 54. Jim Gresko of Forked River has a birthday.
Jim, happy birthday.
It's Angela Hirsch's birthday from Absecon. Angela is 53. Helen Beer of Clayton is 47. Kimberly Bellis of Seaville is 47.
Happy birthday, Kim.
And happy birthday to Bon from Hamilton. Somebody reached out on our Cat Country 107.3 app and said, say happy birthday to me, but didn't include their name.
All right, Bon. Well, happy birthday.
We know that part of their name is Bon.
It's all we can do.
You're okay. Bon and you're 59 and you're
this,
Hamilton.
This is for you.
Okay, Jelly Roll, Cat Country 107.3. Mornings with Joe and Jahna. It's time for
Cat Country 107.3. Trending up or trending down?
And the question today, we're talking pumpkin spice. Specifically, you can say Starbucks pumpkin spice. Are you over it? Is Starbucks actually your favorite spot to get pumpkin spice? Or do you just think pumpkin spice would just go away forever? And you don't even want to hear it about it anymore. 609-383-1073. That's the number to call. Or you can reach out to us on Facebook. The Cat Country 107.3 Facebook page. Trending up or trending down? Joe Kelly, do you like anything pumpkin?
I like pumpkin ice cream.
Oh, pumpkin spice ice cream? Or does
no,
it have to not be pumpkin
ice
spice?
I don't know that I've ever had anything pumpkin spice. I had pumpkin.
Okay.
Pumpkin ice cream.
I mean, this pumpkin spice is basically just pumpkin just with like a little cinnamon in it.
Yeah,
Angela,
I don't need that cinnamon. Angela pumpkin is good.
She says no to Starbucks, no to pumpkin spice. Someone's got to say it. She said, I'll say it. Someone's got to say it. I'll say it. I'd rather have apple cider or caramel favorites. Okay, Angela said that. Kelly from Williamstown, she says pumpkin spice forever, but pumpkin spice from Starbucks is overrated.
Now, when you say from Starbucks, I'm not a coffee drinker. I've had 3 cups of coffee in my entire life. Are you putting a pumpkin spice into your coffee?
So it's like, yeah. So it's like pumpkin flavored because it's so good.
But
it is so good. I will say this. I do love pumpkin spice. I'm basic like that, I guess. But I don't know if Starbucks is my number one favorite. Don't come for me. Please don't come for me. I feel like it doesn't
matter.
Does
everybody who make coffee make pumpkin spice coffee now?
Yes, pretty much. That would be accurate. I go to Dunkin' almost every single day. Love their pumpkin spice too. Starbucks can take several seats as far as I'm concerned. There, I said it. There, I said it.
They can take several seats?
Yes, I said it.
What does that mean?
It means that they can sit down. I don't necessarily think they're the best. Dunkin' is just as good.
Why do they need several seats?
But you, because
is their butt that big that it needs to take up several seats, like on an airplane?
Yeah, absolutely. Buy the extra seats. Please sit down in them. So you let us know. Pumpkin spice, trending up or trending down? 609-383-1073 on all the socials and on the Cat Country 107.3 app. Click the message button.
Cat Country 107.3, trending up or trending down?
Trivia in the meantime.
Cat Country 107.3, trending up or trending down?
It's all about pumpkin spice this morning. Does pumpkin spice need to go or are we obsessed with it for life? 609-383-1073, or you can message us on the Cat Country 107.3 app. Click the message us button. Reach out to us on Facebook, Instagram, all the things. Pumpkin spice, trending up, trending down. Is Starbucks overrated? Does pumpkin spice as a whole need to go? Mm-hmm. You tell us. Now, I'm going to get yelled at because my mom has always had very strong opinions about this. She texted me and said I better share her answer. So Trish the Dish says, a.k.a. Jahna's mom, says, way, way too much pumpkin, Jahna. You know this. I say this every year. This pumpkin, the pumpkin this, pumpkin that, pumpkin everything, pumpkin air spray, pumpkin drinks, pumpkin cereal. Who knows what it's going to be next? Pumpkin toilet paper. She said we don't need it.
You have pumpkin cereal?
Mm-hmm.
And oh, a pumpkin yeah. hairspray?
Air spray, like the scented,
oh,
like the room
air
spray. Yeah, yeah. So Trish the Dish, Jahna's mom.
Your bathroom smells like a big pumpkin. Over.
Mine does, yeah, though, okay. But I have a Scentsy in my bathroom. And
that's,
it plugged
that's a
in.
Great story.
And so, that yeah, that's plugged in there.
Jess from Galloway says, Starbucks pumpkin chai. Is that how you pronounce it?
Yeah,
see,
chai.
I know nothing about coffee.
Yes.
It's amazing. She said, could care less about the latte.
Jess from Galloway, thanks for messaging us on the app. And then we have, oh my goodness gracious, we have Nicole from Washington Township on Instagram. You could have just commented, Nicole. You didn't have to DM us, but you can always do that too. That's absolutely fine. But she says pumpkin spice forever. That's all she wrote.
Addie McCreary, U Time. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. High Country Morning Trivia is on the air. Phone number is 609-383-1073. Or hit the call us button on the Cat Country 107.3 app.
That's probably the easiest way to do it.
Price today, two tickets to see the big guy, Trace Adkins. He's going to be at the Hard Rock Hotel and Casino in Atlantic City tomorrow night. Matter of fact, Trace is going to be joining us again about 8:20 this morning. But he's at the Hard Rock tomorrow night. You've got two tickets when you win. Trace Adkins, Hard Rock tomorrow night. Here's the question. 4 out of 10 people, Jahna, say this is their favorite smell of summer.
Am I allowed to guess?
No.
Fine.
Yes, you can guess. One guess.
I'm going to guess freshly cut grass?
No.
Oh.
4 out of 10 people say this is their favorite summer smell. 107.3 with Joe and Jahna. Trace Adkins at the Hard Rock Hotel and Casino in Atlantic City tomorrow night. He's also going to join us on the show a little bit after 8:20. But right now, we've got tickets to give away to see Trace Adkins on Morning Trivia. There's two tickets to the Hard Rock Hotel and Casino tomorrow night to see Trace Adkins. Here's the question. 4 out of 10 people say this is their favorite smell of summer. You said...
I said fresh cut grass.
And I said your mom. Neither of them correct.
Neither one right. Sorry.
Hi, Cat Country.
Hey, is this funnel cake?
Funnel cake is not it. Thank you. Ooh, that smells good.
It does smell good.
Hi, Cat Country. What's your answer?
Is it sunscreen?
Sunscreen or suntan lotion. That's right. You're a winner. And Cat Country 107.3. Mornings with Joe and Jahna. A big shout out to our neighbors around the block, literally around the block from us. The headquarters in RNA Harbor Township for Spencer's Gifts and Spirit Halloween Store. And they were just involved in they were actually kind of highlighted, he'll say in quotes, on Saturday Night Live the other night.
Well,
did you see the skit?
It was so funny. It really was funny, but
it was true.
It was true, but
they made fun of the fact that Spirit Halloween stores
just snatches up every empty store within the first 5 minutes of the previous business vacating.
But a big shout out to whoever's running social media around the block.
They need a raise at Spirit Halloween. Whoever's doing it,
they came back against Saturday Night Live with some pretty good social media stuff, including the irrelevant 50-year-old TV show costume.
The irrelevant 50-year-old TV show costume with, what is it?
Dated references.
Includes.
Unknown cast members.
And shrinking ratings.
Shrinking ratings. So.
It's the best.
Good job there at Spirit Halloween in Egg Harbor Township. By the way, can you guys make a Joe and Jahna costume? At least,
please,
you know, the package
it.
For social media. We'd love one of those.
That would be so funny.
Thank you. Good morning. We're...
This October, Tanger invites you to shop pink and save lives. Your donation of $10 or more to the Breast Cancer Research Foundation helps fuel innovative research that brings us closer to a cure. It also unlocks exclusive savings from brands like Coach, Crocs, Columbia Factory Store, and more to shop all month long. Join us as we mark 30 years of advancing research and empowering hope. Donate and access your exclusive savings today at Tanger.com.
Things you need to know this morning. Just how high was your electric bill last month? A congressional panel will be holding a public hearing next Tuesday into a surge in bills for customers of Atlantic City Electric.
I got bills. I got to pay. Yep.
I Congressman Jeff Van Drew is hosting the field hearing at the Atlanta County Institute of Technology Performing Arts Center in Mays Landing. In a statement announcing the hearing, some customers have said their bills increased by as much as 400% this summer.
That's outrageous. Well, a major strike by thousands of members of the International Longshoremen Association right here in New Jersey and elsewhere has led to consumer panic buying of toilet paper despite no direct threat to its supply. Now, that isn't panic here. That was from Australia during the pandemic when fights broke out over toilet paper. Oh my gosh, social media posts show empty shelves at retailers like Costco, fueling concerns of a shortage. However, experts attribute the perceived shortage to hoarding behavior rather than actual supply issues. Most toilet paper in the U.S. is produced domestically. Manufacturers have adequate buffer inventory. So,
and you have 10 more days to experience Gillian's Water Wonderland Pier in Ocean City. After 94 years, the Boardwalk Amusement Park will be closing forever a week from Friday.
It's so sad. But your South Jersey weather for today, some morning clouds and some afternoon sun with a high of 74.
Weather brought to you by Atlantic City Electric. Storm season is here. Atlantic City Electric knows a little prep makes a big difference. See how you can stay connected during storms. Prepare to weather any weather at AtlanticCityElectric.com/ 3107.3 Mornings with Joe and Jahna. Time now for my favorite tweets from the last 24 hours.
All right, here we go.
First of all, shout out to the guy who ridiculed me on social media that I'm still calling it Twitter.
Nobody calls it X,
thank
bro.
You. Thank you.
Ew, what are you, friggin' 50?
Thank you. And if they're not tweets, what are they, X's?
Yeah, nobody calls it X. Can you stop?
All right, here we go. My favorite tweets, number one.
Ew.
If you innocently act like you just don't know, people will explain dirty words to you, and it's hilarious.
Yeah. Connecticut is awkward.
Mother what?
And yeah.
Number two. Yeah. It's been 0 days since that one coworker was a total jerk. Yeah.
Well.
Number three. My cookbook is just a bunch of pizza place menus stapled together.
If it works, it works.
Maybe a sub place too.
Yeah.
Number
Chinese.
Four. Number four. Wife, can you wake me up at 3 o'clock? I'm taking a nap. Me, why don't you set an alarm? Wife, I can't stand the alarm noise. Oh, but me waking you up is fine? Wife, it gives me an opportunity to be mad at you.
See? Even if for 5 minutes.
We know. We're Joe and Jahna. These are my favorite tweets. Last one, number five. The dude who invented the autocorrect has died. May he restaurant in peace. Cat Country 107.3, Mornings with Joe and Jahna. It is time for Cash Cow.
Trying to hook you up with money right now.
$30,000 is the top prize. We're going to give you 10 chances to win today. Every hour, 20 minutes past the hour from now to 5:20 p.m., listen for the code. Go to the Cat Country 107.3 app, tap on the button that says win $30,000 cash, type in the code, and you could be our big winner on Cash Cow, powered by Bennett Chevy and BennettChevy.com. Here's your first code of the day, your 8:20 a.m. code, 244.
244, that's easy enough. 2 times 2 is what? 4 plus 0 is what? 4. 244.
You just made it complicated by throwing in the zero. There's no zero. 244.
244, that's the number that you need. That's the code. You're going to type it in when you hit the win $30,000 button on the Cat Country 107.3 app. 244, we'll be back in an hour with your next.
Insider our game show Sunrise Challenge, which comes your way at 5:45. Trace is going to be at the Hard Rock Hotel and Casino in Atlantic City tomorrow night. And he's back with us right now. Welcome back. Thank you, Trace. Good morning.
My pleasure.
You're going to be performing in the Hard Rock Friday, which used to be owned by, of course, Donald Trump. Was one of Trump's properties, the building was. And you, of course, have some history with Donald Trump. You were on Celebrity Apprentice. You finished second your first time. And then you,
and
won,
then you won the
All-Star
whole thing.
Celebrity Apprentice.
Yeah.
I can sense your enthusiasm already.
I know, right?
Did this actually do anything for you? Did you learn anything? Or was it kind of a TV show?
No, I did learn something. Because when I first went for that very first season, I really felt like I was going to be a fish out of water and wasn't going to be able to compete with those folks who had... Who had more city savvy and business acumen than I had. And after I was there for a couple of weeks, I started to realize that, you know, I could play ball with those folks. So I gained a little confidence from that whole thing and made a lot of good friends. And it didn't hurt me.
You certainly did a great job. Now, here's the question. If Donald Trump calls you in January and says, Trace Atkins, I want you to join my cabinet at the White House, what would you say?
Would you say yes?
I'd take an ambassador gig, but I don't want to be on the cabinet.
Ambassador sounds good. Somewhere warm.
Yeah,
tropical.
I was going to say that could work out in
somewhere,
your favor.
Yeah, a vacation destination, you know, wherever that may be. That's my ambassador gig.
So we got to forward that. We'll forward that along to Mr. Trump for sure. That way we can put it in the suggestion box at the very least for you. So we've mentioned already that you dabble in a lot of different things, which is kind of, I think, especially for, I'll call like us younger kids looking up to you. You're like the definition of like, don't put yourself in a box. Like, do whatever you want to do and just try anything. You have been in movies and TV shows, and most recently you got to star alongside Susan Sarandon. I loved Monarch. It was incredible. How did it feel going up, like just playing off of like such a legendary Academy Award winning actor like that?
I know. It was terribly intimidating. The very first day we had a makeout scene. That was the first scene we did. You know? And it was like, I couldn't even believe that it was just the most surreal thing I think I've ever done in my life. And the whole, every day that I worked with her was just, you know, she was awesome and very giving and unselfish, and I enjoyed every minute of it.
That's great. How do you manage your time with all these different things going on in your life?
I don't manage it very well. There are people that I care a lot about that I don't get to spend as much time with as I'd like to. So I don't know that I do manage well.
Cat Country 107.3, where Joe and Jahna were talking with Trace Adkins. He's at the Hard Rock Friday night. Trace, how's this show Friday night? How's your recent shows? How do they differ from a show you were doing 10 or 15 years ago?
Oh, yeah. Hopefully I've gotten better at it. I my voice is still good. You know, I can still sing everything. I recorded in the same key that I recorded it in, and I don't know what to attribute that to. Really, my voice is holding up really well, and as long as that's the case, you know, and people want to hear it, I guess I'll keep doing it. One of the things we're excited about this Atlantic City show is the Hard Rock gave like 100 tickets to some local Air Force guys, and we're looking forward to seeing them.
Trace Adkins, thanks for joining us on Cat Country. We'll see you Friday night at the Hard Rock.
Look forward to it. Thank you, guys.
She was staring out the window of their SUV, complaining, saying, I can't wait to turn 18. She said, I'll make my own money, and I'll make my own rules. Mama put the car in park out there in front of the school. And she kissed her head and said, I was just like you. You're gonna miss this. You're gonna want this back. You're gonna wish these days hadn't gone by so fast. These are some good times. So take a good look around. You're gonna miss this. Before she knows it, she's a brand new bride in her one bedroom apartment, and her daddy stops by. He tells her it's a nice place. She says, it'll do for now. Starts talking about babies and buying a house. Daddy shakes his head and says, baby, just slow down. Cause you're gonna miss this. You're gonna want this back. You're gonna wish these days hadn't gone by so fast. These are some good times. So take a good look around. You're gonna miss this. 5 years later, there's a plumber working on the water heater. Dogs barking, phones ringing. One kid's crying, one kid's screaming. And she keeps apologizing.
Once 36, once 23. It's hard to believe, but you're gonna miss this. You're gonna want this back. You're gonna wish these days hadn't gone by so fast. These are some good times, so take a good look.
Mornings with Joe and Jahna. That's Trace Atkins. He's at the Hard Rock tomorrow night. Thanks to Trace for joining us this morning on CAC.
Wesley Financial Group is not a law firm.
Do you find yourself stuck in a timeshare? Get the real facts about the timeshare industry and your options for cancellation. Chuck McDowell, founder of Wesley Financial Group, has put together a free information guide that reveals the secrets the timeshare industry doesn't want you to know, including the five ways to get rid of your timeshare. Get this timeshare cancellation guide absolutely free.
Get your free guide at iCancelTimeshare.com. That's iCancelTimeshare.com. iCancelTimeshare.com.